Popplet Lite is a simple and easy to use app for making brainstorming, concept mapping, mind maps, and storyboarding.
So when you first open up Popplet Lite, you get a blank screen. You can change the background color. So on the tab there that shows the color, just choose one of those and it will change the background color for you. To insert a box, a poplet, you just double tap and it puts a box in for you. It automatically comes up with a range of options on that box. So the first one, I'll actually make the box bigger, the tab in the bottom right hand corner, the triangle, you can click on that and drag the box to make it bigger. Okay, so there's a few things you can do. The first one on the left is just a border, so you can change the border color. So let's make it red. The next one, you can insert some text, so you can actually type in some text. You've got left align, right align, center align, and you've also got text size buttons. So there's some good options there. You can also freehand draw in the Popplet. Choose a color, and away you go. You can draw whatever you like. And the last option looks like a sort of landscape photo picture. If you click on that, you can actually open up your camera library and insert an image from there. Gives you options to rotate the image first, click done, and that inserts into the Popplet. So to make a multiple Popplet page, you can basically drag on one of these grey dots on the sides. If you actually click on one, drag it out, it will make another Popplet for you. And you can just keep dragging and clicking them out. You can click on a Popplet and move it. If you want to get rid of an arrow in between, you just tap on the arrow and it will come up with a cross. Press on the cross and it removes the Popplet. The usual pinch and zoom to zoom in and out on the objects, so you can go and have a closer look. And so this works fantastically well for a whole range of ideas. You could do brainstorming, storyboarding, photo, montages, and the possibilities are quite extensive. You can make multiple links between Popplets. So if we want to link this one to the one down in the bottom left there, grab on the grey tag, pull the grey tab across, and it'll link that Popplet. And then if we actually want to link this Popplet to the other one as well, grab on the grey tag, drag it up, and it will link. So now we've got a multi-linked mind map, and the links move as you move the boxes. So it's quite good. So let's look at a couple of other things we can do. I'm just going to make a three Popplet mind map of global warming, very simple. But if I click on this Popplet, I've got some text in there already. I actually want to remove the text and I want to remove the drawing. So if I click on the drawing tool, there's a tab right down the bottom that says clear drawing. If I click on that, it'll remove the drawing that's already in there. And if I click on the text button, it will let me change the text that's in there. So increased temperatures, going to make the text a bit smaller. And then on this other one, need to put some text in there. Let's make that one a bit bigger. Okay, so quite easily and quickly, we've made a little mind map of global warming. You're going to have melting ice caps, you're going to have increased temperatures. A few other options. If you think you're finished with your mind map, you can lock the screen so you can't actually make any changes to it, but we'll unlock that for now. You can copy a Popplet, so if you click and hold on it, it'll come up with copy, and then if you click somewhere else on the screen, it'll come up with paste, so you can duplicate your concepts. If you want to get rid of the concept, you'll notice up in the top right hand corner there's a little cross, so press on that, it'll ask if you want to delete the Popplet. So we've deleted that. Another option, instead of moving the Popplets one at a time, you can actually highlight multiple Popplets and move them together. So for example, let's move these two diagrams. So you use two fingers and tap on the Popplet, and now with one finger, I move the two at once, so I can reposition those wherever I like. On the Lite version, there's a few different options for exporting. You can email a PDF, a JPEG, or save a JPEG to your camera roll. So some simple options, but they're quite good. Students can make a concept map, storyboard, and email it to you. So So if you see there, we saved the JPEG to the photo library. So that'll now appear in our photo library. And there it is. I've gone into my photo library application, and there is the mind map that I've made in Popplet Lite. You can give your mind maps a name. So up in the top left-hand corner, above the tags, there's the title. If you just click in that area, you can actually just type in a new name. Okay, so I've renamed that mind map. An excellent feature on the Popplet app, if you click on the help button, it actually takes you to a Popplet that they've made that explains how you can use it, and they give you an example of some of the uses. So on this one, they've jotted down thoughts and like an organisation mind map tool. That one's sort of a classification chart you might see in sort of some sciences, biology. They've used sort of a photo montage of a school camp or a trip, and you can do a few other things. So write in there, select multiple popples, do freehand drawings, insert photos. So that gives you some good ideas as well.